Hi everyone, so this is lesson three, which is parametric differentiation. All you do is differentiate each one. Now I have a slightly different way of writing this, because if you follow the chain rule, the dt's cancelling, and then it's the same as 1 over, so that's just the same as dividing, isn't it? So dy by dx is dy by dt, divided by dx by dt. So I do it that way just to make it quick and easy. So that's my way of doing it. No faffing around. Just differentiate them both first. And that's all you need to do. Right, so let's have a look at this first example. So x is 4 ln t. So differentiate it, dx by dt. Ln t, or ln x, goes to 1 over x. So ln t goes to 1 over t. I've got 4 times by 1 over t. I've got 4 over t. Job jobbed. Y is 6 e to the 4 t. So dy, y on the left, t on the right, bring the 4 down, it's going to be 24 e to the 4 t. And then I'm just going to use what I've got in the box there, which is dy by dx is dy by dt divided by dx by dt. So dy by dx is 24 e to the 4t divided by 4 over 2. So 24 over 4 cancels down as a 6. Divide by 1 over 2 flips it and times it. So dy by dx is 6t e to the 4t. There. Oh, I've got lots of this. Oh my word, you have to write smaller this one, don't you? So I've got that. Find the gradient when t is 1. Oh, that's all right then. So when t is 1, dy by dx is 6, lots of 1. E to the 4, lots of 1. So that's just 6 e to the 4. So that's fine. Stationary point, so C, that's when dy by dx is 0, isn't it? Alright, so let's have a look then. So where is it? 6t e to the 4t, so differentiate it down now. 6t e to the 4t is 0. So 6t is 0, t is nothing. E to the 4t is 0. And this one has no solutions because t has to be greater than 0 because your e graph, zip, there. Or e to the 4t, sorry, not 2. E to the 4t has to be greater than 0. There we go. Right, so let's check this. Now, let's get a bit tricky with this now. I think my stationary point is at t is 0. But if I sub in t is 0, I've got x is 4 ln of 0. But if you look at the log graph doesn't, that's for x is greater than 0. So although my maths thinks that t is 0 is a stationary point, it actually doesn't have any stationary points. Stationary points. It's a bit cheeky, isn't it, really? So you're quite bold if t is nothing, that'll do us. But actually, if I try and get the coordinate of it, the 4 and 0 doesn't work. Right, there's one for you there next to it. So let me just reveal that. So have a go at this, please. So maybe we get a bit lazy and not even bothering to copy this off the off the screen. Do you have time to do that? So there's another couple of examples, so I might just zip on and do the next one. Hopefully I won't run out of time. So what do we want? So we want, find the coordinates where the tangent is parallel to each axis. So if it's parallel to the x-axis, it's just going that way. It's just a stationary point. But if it's parallel to the y-axis, this is where we've got to be a bit more careful. Right, so let's go for it then. So let's differentiate first. So if I've got x is theta minus 2 sine theta. So sine cos minus cos. Sine goes to, well, minus sine goes to minus cos. So dx by d theta is 1 minus 2 cos theta. And y is 1 minus cos theta. So that the 1 disappears, the minus cos becomes sine theta. So dy by dx is dy by d theta divided by dx by d theta. So dy by dx is sine, whoops, theta over 1 minus 2 cos theta. Right, now then. I've mentioned this before, where if it's a stationary point, it has no change in y. Because remember, we've got like a gradient, there's a change going up divided by, that's not a change, it's the E of a change going across. The board keeps getting a bit funny. So for a stationary point, I've got lots of change across, but no change above. Which says the top line is equal to zero. So for the x-axis, I'm saying it's just a normal stationary point, but what I'm actually saying is that the top line, which is the change going up, is equal to zero. So I've got sine theta is equal to zero, and that would give me out 0 on pi, so, yeah, because theta's from 0 to pi, isn't it? So then for the coordinates of it, if I sub it in, the 0, so if I sub my 0 in, I'll try and do it here, this little gap. So for theta is 0, if I sub it in, it'd be 0 minus 2 lots of sine 0, which would be nothing. And then it will be 1 minus cos of 0, which is 1 minus 1, which is nothing. And then for theta is pi, so use the note on the pi, because that's what it's going between. So for pi, it will be pi minus 2 sine pi, which would be just be pi. And then for 1 minus cos of pi, it'd be 1 minus a minus 1, so that'll give you 2. There we go. So those are my coordinates for it. Right, so let's have a look at the other one now for the y-axis, part B. So it's parallel to the y-axis. So I have no change going across. So I've got to think about it. It's a basic gradient. Change going up divided by change going across. That's what I'm saying then. So my bottom line, my 1 minus 2 cos theta, is equal to zero. So a half is cos theta if I rearrange it. Now that gives me theta out as pi by 3. Now think about with a cos graph. It's just that. There, go with that one. In my mind, I think there's another one as well. But, so I've got theta from 0 to pi. I think if you've got your cos graph, no, we're okay actually. If I'm just looking from 0 to pi, I've only got the one value, haven't I, for pi by 3, which is there. Nope, just the one value. Whereas with the sine graph, I have 2. Right, so if I sub in there, so I've got, so for the x value, I would have, I'll do it properly, I'll have pi by 3 minus, actually, I'm running out of time. Minus 2 sine pi by 3, which is going to be pi by 3 minus root 3. Oh, I'm going to let me pause it just while I do this. There, nearly run out of time then, but that's the coordinate I get for it. There's another example, I'll do that on a separate vid now. Okay, see you later, bye.